This is Right On by Final Draft. I'm your host, Pete D'Alessandro, product manager here at Final Draft. This is the screenwriting podcast where we talk about all things screenwriting. And today we're going to be talking about the Austin Film Festival, the screenwriting competition, and all that goes with it. This year was the 25th Austin Film Festival, so big year for Austin. Joining us today is producer Kayla Guess. Kayla, thank you so much for being on the podcast today.
Thanks for having me on. It's actually funny to be on because I'm always behind the scenes.
You're always the one listening. You're our first listener.
Yes.
So let's talk about why Final Draft feels that going to the Austin Film Festival is important.
We go to the Austin Film Festival specifically because the Austin Film Festival is very screenwriter-centric. The roundtables, the panels, much of its programming is focused on the craft of screenwriting.
Kayla, this was your first time at the Austin Film Festival. What did you expect and what did you get out of this?
I really wasn't sure what to expect, except that a lot of the people that I work with within the industry have always described Austin as their favorite film festival. So my only expectation was to have a good time. But what I got out of it was pretty incredible because for the first time I had the opportunity to meet a great deal of the finalists in the Big Break contest, which I also direct. I don't usually get that kind of interaction with our finalists. I typically get to communicate with them only via email, social media, and the telephone. So it was really nice to congratulate our finalists face to face.
It is interesting that there is a decent amount of overlap between a lot of the higher people in the contest at Austin and some of the finalists in Big Break.
I do happen to know that we also share some of the same readers. So I think that it speaks to the level of both of our contests and being able to meet some of my finalists and find out that they are reaching the same point within the Austin Film Festival. It was a pretty cool experience to celebrate both wins for them.
It's an awesome track record to get going in through 2018, finishing up 2018.
And you got to meet some of our customers who you build the product for.
That was interesting as product manager because I get to sort of see how people react to the product live. So we even had a booth set up where we, you know, had a TV screen and showed different features like the beatboard and just kind of watching people's reactions to it and then walking people through those features and really understanding what it's going to mean to them. And that really gets to inform you as a product manager as to what people really need next and what needs to change, what you need to preserve specifically. How do people like how it's working right now? And you get to see all that in front of new writers, people who are completely unbiased and don't necessarily have anything invested. So it's a nice way to kind of gain insight into a lot of how our users feel.
What was your favorite feature to show off?
It was great to see people react to the beatboard, especially with all the improvements, like, you know, being able to just drag an image in from your desktop and land it on the beatboard as a new beat, and all the new colors seemed to be a really big hit. But combining all that really shows what's possible, and I think that was really neat for people to see. It's great to have a blank canvas to start on, that's what the beatboard is, but it's really nice to see what a completed canvas would look like in a script that's actually been written already using those features, and it really gives you the picture of like, oh, here is what I would be doing if I was thinking of this the first time. Here is what I might shape my ideas out to be if it happened to work out that way. That complete picture, I think, is really enlightening for people.
Watching you show off your baby to our customers was also pretty enjoyable because we watch actual jaws drop, like when we showed features like speech to script.
Yeah.
Watching people dictate their dialogue on the big screen was fun to watch.
Yeah, it was flattering and also humbling just that people are really that into it.
Yes.
And, you know, you spend 2 years building something like Final Draft 11 and then you just don't know. You're sort of in a vacuum in a lot of ways. I mean, we certainly talk to a lot of customers. We have a lot of beta testers and surveys, and we watch people use the program. But it's not the same as having something already out in the wild and watching people react to it.
Another fun part for both of us at the festival was being able to attend the panels and
yes.
the roundtables, and also getting to speak with some of the professional writers that were part of the programming.
Yeah, I was really interested to see what people would say about the Austin Film Festival and exactly what they thought was so valuable. Kayla, you caught up with Katie Daly, Director of Strategic Partnerships of Austin Film Festival, to ask her what's different about the Austin Film Festival versus others.
It was great to catch up with her as we work hand in hand with from the time we start thinking about the next year to setting up the booth at Austin.
I think something that is unique to AFF that you don't get at a lot of other festivals is that we don't put up walls or VIP areas. Everybody's going to the same parties. Everyone's sitting in the Driscoll bar together, going to the same films. So you really can, if you're a teacher trying to break in as a writer or filmmaker, you can sit down with the Kelly Currys and the Shane Blacks and the Larry Wilmores of the world and see where they got their start.
Sticking with what's different about Austin Film Festival, Pete, you also got to catch up with Stephany Folsom, who is the writer behind Toy Story 4. How did that go?
She always has a lot to say and a lot of great insight. Here she is.
I think it's the only film festival I've been to where writers are actually a focus and put at the center. And it's kind of a great thing where story and writer is put forefront. It's often hard to find.
And then you caught up with Kat Candler, writer and producer on Queen Sugar, after her roundtable.
Yes, which was a good time for me because as a person who was attending for the first time, she is an Austin local.
The experience of festivals and conferences like this, it's the community that you build. It's the people that you sit next to in a theater or stand with in line that you strike up a conversation with and that you meet from a different city. And it's those very organic connections and friendships that are built with 1, 2, 5, 10 people that are going to last next year and the year beyond that. And then the writers groups that get formed because of those connections and those friendships. And then the jobs that you get hired for because of those connections that you made like 2 or 3 years ago.
And Kelly, you caught up with Carly Wray.
Carly is known for writing on shows such as Mad Men, Westworld, The Leftovers. So it was really great to catch up with her just after jumping off of her panel.
And she had one piece of advice for attendees in the future.
I think that my number one piece of advice for writers in particular is to step outside of your comfort zone while you're here and talk to as many people as you can. Talk about what you're working on. Ask people what they're working on. Be a little bit bolder than you might naturally be. And I know that there are some writers who definitely have that instinct. It was always very difficult for me, and I've already spoken to a few people here who are like, it's just
an introverted thread in
a lot of really great writers that keep you from going out and not selling yourself, but just making yourself known, making yourself available.
Yeah.
You know, and this is such a great place for that because everyone's here for that reason. Everyone's open to it and excited about the fact that we're all doing the same thing. So going up after panels and talking, I can say, as a panelist, I'm always excited to have those interactions.
So you do welcome that, because I guess
course,
as writers,
yeah,
maybe are wondering if waiting to speak to you after the panel is bothersome or a nuisance. But you welcome it.
I welcome it. Have a good sense of boundaries. Any given panelist is probably not going to be able to read 100 scripts, or I can't get you a job. I can't. But asking questions about the way that things work and introducing yourself, and even I'm always open to someone saying, listen, this is where I'm at in my career. When you were at where I'm at, what did you do? What was helpful? What were the roadblocks that you found?
Kayla, you also talked to Grace Moss, NBC Director of Talent Development and Inclusion, after her fellowship panel.
Some speakers are there for other purposes, like Grace Moss, who attends Austin Film Festival to also discover new voices. I have been working with Grace via email actually for the last couple of years, and we support their programming as much as they support our contest. So it was really great to catch up with her in person and talk about her fellowship panel.
Full of very passionate and inspired storytellers who are very eager to pursue these fellowships and labs is great because there's so many opportunities that the industry offers, whether it's from the network, studio, from the nonprofits, the grant. I'm so glad that people are taking advantage of these resources and really trying to do their best to get in, because they're great programs that writers should take advantage of.
And Pete, you also spoke with Stephany on why it's important to come as a panelist.
I think you get a lot of inspiration, and also there's a little bit of a sense of like, oh yeah, I've struggled with that in my work as well, and you're struggling with that too. And it kind of makes the journey of writing a little bit easier to know that you're not alone in your journey.
Yes.
So often you're just sitting there with you and your computer and your self-hatred. So to have other people be like, oh no, you're on the same road I am too, and we can be on that road together is really great.
Pete, you've been coming to Austin Film Festival for a few years now. What kinds of things should we be doing in terms of preparing for attending?
Preparing is the right word. So this is my third year at Austin, and honestly, the big thing is scheduling, figuring out what panels you want to attend, figuring out what panelists you're interested in hearing from, and researching them in advance. Really figuring out what it is you want to try to hear from them. You're going to get the chance to ask questions from the audience. You're going to see these people around the festival. So have something prepared, know what you need to ask, and make sure you're not asking the same question 700 other people are asking. Try to get a step ahead of that. The other thing you can do to prepare is there is an electronic app, electronic calendar.
I learned about that too late.
Yes, there's an electronic calendar. There's also a paper calendar. Things change rapidly. So I find the paper calendar to be misleading because I've written stuff down that's no longer true, and that tends to throw me. So I would say absolutely find a way to use the app. They can even sync your calendar with your own Gmail calendar, and then you pick out which panels you want to attend, and they change in real time.
And to further your point about better preparing, when we caught up with Kat Candler, she also shared what you can do to prepare for next year.
For me, the experience of festivals and conferences like this, it's the community that you build. It's the people that you sit next to in a theater or stand with in line, that you strike up a conversation with, and that you meet from a different city, and it's those very organic connections and friendships that are built with 1, 2, 5, 10 people that are going to last next year and beyond that. And then the writers groups that get formed because of those connections and those friendships, and then the jobs that you get hired for because of those connections that you made like 2 or 3 years ago. For me, it's always the community and the community building behind festivals and conferences that I love so much.
And then here's Carly Wray on how she feels about not attending earlier in her career.
I had a script many years ago now go to the second round, but I didn't come to the festival.
Do you regret that now that you see all the finalists here?
I do, because I feel like it would have, if nothing else, it would make you feel less alone as a writer who's trying to break into the business.
Kayla, what do you think your favorite part of Austin was?
It was really, for me, it was about experiencing the culture that is Austin Film Festival, getting to share that experience with our Big Break finalists and with some of the folks that I see at our networking events that we have here in Los Angeles, getting to be in that special space with our writing community was a really cool experience for me.
I think for me it was that there are over 10,000 entries into this screenplay competition at Austin, and that is impressive, but never know who you're going to be in that same room with, how many people are going to be totally novices and not really know what they're asking, not know what they're talking about. And you know what? People were really wise. They were well-educated. They knew what they were talking about. They were prepared. And they were really professional. And I think there are a lot of people there who are really going to make careers for themselves this year. I was really impressed by just the other attendees to sit next to.
It was actually exciting to be at the different networking events and happy hours that are put on by the programming. Just speaking to some of these newer writers, these finalists, and imagining where they will be in the next year, in the next 5 years.
Can't wait to try and beg some of those people for jobs at some point.
We've actually had some of the past finalists on our podcast that you've met at these networking events. So you've personally seen some of these careers develop as a result of the festival.
We have. I mean, we've seen some people come up through 1 year at a time, just one staff writing job and a couple of spec episodes, and then actually really running their own shows.
There's definitely a different energy around Austin Film Festival. I did forget a special mention to the barbecue. The barbecue was incredible, and the live music was everywhere. Everywhere that we walked from event to event that were off-site, you can just hear the streets being filled with the local music.
The Austin Film Festival would not be the Austin Film Festival in any other city. That is definitely a part of the festival, that culture, the local culture. And to reiterate, the barbecue. Let's not understate that.
In closing, as an Austin vet, we'll call you, what is the most important takeaway from Austin Film Festival for you?
The big takeaway for me is community. This is a collection of screenwriters that really does not exist anywhere else. So people who are into screenwriting, even if they are totally professional and know what they're doing and have been working in the industry for years, people that are just starting out, or everyone in between who are scraping away every day at the next script, all those people are here, and they aren't anywhere else at the same time. This never happens anywhere else. So this is the one time a year to really get embedded in that community and feel your peers and feel the energy coming off them, get that inspiration, bring it home, put it into your next draft.
I love it.
That will wrap it up for Right On by Final Draft about the 25th Austin Film Festival. Thank you to Kayla Guest, producer.
Thank you for having me. Again, it's fun to be on here with you for a change.
And thank you out there for listening to us. If you like the podcast, please subscribe on iTunes. Please leave us one of those ratings or reviews that all your friends are leaving for us. Very flattering to us. Make sure to check out the Austin Film Festival next year. And until next time, right on.